What's up, guys? I am back with another Eurovision 19 reaction. United Kingdom. I have not heard any buzz about this yet, so that leads me to believe that it's neither on people's bottom of the list or top of the list. I know politically speaking, yada yada, it always plays a part in how people are going to vote, so there's that. But even my British friends aren't really talking about it a whole lot, so I'm not really sure how it's going to go. Personally, I feel like they've upped their game a lot in the past, I don't know, 5 years especially. Lucy Jones was a great addition to the Eurovision catalog, although, I mean, we kind of knew it wasn't going to win, but I really enjoyed it, so I'm not really sure what to expect. Their performer this year is Michael Rice. Never heard of him, but that's not uncommon for Eurovision. The song is called Bigger Than Us. So I'm assuming this is going to be another kind of quasi-political message of unity and strength and universal synergy. There, we'll put a title on it. But all assumptions aside, let's see what they got. And it looks like there's not a official music video out yet for this, so this is the final. They brought the Lucy Jones background stars back. Okay. So we're getting some Sam Smith vibes, which is a safe move. I don't know anybody who really hates Sam Smith music. So, all right, I gotta quick pause. So you can see me frowning. I don't dislike the song, but his really specific choreography is kind of throwing me off, because it seems like it's really well thought through, but he's still thinking about it too hard, and it's kind of taking me away from anything else that's going on. There's time. Yeah, just the pointing at the audience has never flown with me. It's like, you're not looking at me. Yeah, this is overly staged to the minutia. Yep. Okay, I just gotta not look at it. He has a good voice. It's good beat. Everybody can sway and clap to it, obviously. Couple notes dropped, but nothing major, nothing he can improve on. Good melismas. Are we gonna key change? Yes, key change! Okay, UK, this is a moment. Don't ruin it with your staging. Okay, so now I'm getting some actual emotion from him and not one, two, three, kneel. Yep, it's a good little flip up to his falsetto and right back down. Don't lock your knees, and you'll get that. He's adorable. Okay, so he's clearly likable. It is not at all my style of music. It's anything that like harkens toward boy band type of feel. I get a little like cringy about. But there's something really genuine about what he's doing. And even though the message has been told over and over and over again, it's still a good message. So I'm hoping that people will kind of pick up on it. I don't think this will be last. Yeah. All right, UK. This, yeah, that last bit is really powerful. The key change works. It doesn't seem like it's just a key change for the sake of having one in a Eurovision song. But I get nervous every time that the staging just won't elevate it and might actually bring it down, or the costuming sometimes. It's just a really weird choice with the lights. So I have high hopes, and I want to see UK do well, even if the voting doesn't match it. But let me know what you think. Is this on your radar at all? What were the other songs at the national final like? Did you like one better? Were you surprised this made it? Let me know, and we'll catch up on the next video. Thanks, guys.